Hey guys, finally got it up. As of some of y'all know on Instagram that I got a new basketball hoop. It's a Lifetime 90 90270. And so here's the lowest position that goes down to 7.5. Yeah, it's the lowest that goes down to. And then here's the highest. They're just in 3-inch increments. And the slam at rim is made to do some monstrous dunks. What's going on, guys? KiaBase879. Back again for my Lifetime basketball hoop. You can go to my 1 month review video. There's a video I did 2 years ago when I first bought it. Back when my brother had a great Nissan Sentra in the driveway. But anyways, let me go over some stuff I had to do the 2.5 year time I had it. If you go back to my other review, I had this. You notice this piece right here was all silver. And these bolts are silver. And to protect the parts of the basketball hoop from rusting, let me find the bottle rubber coating. Hold on, let me get a good view of the basketball hoop. So on rubberized coat that put flex seal. I should rubberize weak seal on the bolts on the whole adjustment mechanism. Well, except for this piece up here in the trigger. Yeah, you can tell this stuff's kind of chipping down here. But you can tell there's like a nick right there. Because I adjusted the basketball hoop while the coating was still wet. But to protect the silver parts from rusting, you are gonna have to add Placidip, or I think Placidip would be better than Leak Seal by Rust-Oleum. The only bad things about this basketball hoop was the backboard gets really swirled easily. If you throw a really rough ball against it, if you throw a rough basketball against it, of course it's gonna get swirl marked. Like, let me get a good angle. I can get the, you kind of see the swirls a little bit right there from the ball hitting the backboard. But that's no big deal. You should get some, Plastex. What is it? The, plastic polish. Polish out the backboard. Maybe put a clear plastic coating over it. And, I'm trying to press all this down so bubbles stop hitting. Getting poked up on this thing, sticking up on this. Anyways, still adjusts up and down after having it for 2.5 years. We tried to scrape this coating. Probably just scrape it all down and get some Placidip. It still adjusts from 7.5 to 10 foot still with the same part from day one. Still adjusts up and down smoothly. The only thing I have to worry about is, after maybe 5 years of having this, because remember when I was 10 years old, I had one that was a 50-inch portable one. I started noticing after 5 years of the portable one, the rim got nicked from it hitting the ground. The all the adjustment parts kept locking up from the rust, but no big deal. You can just take some WD-40. I don't know, probably. It was probably the spring inside of the portable one that went bad. Mine had a different trigger mechanism. It was like more rectangle, like kind of like this. But the springs, they're kind of rusted out. That should be expected from normal wear and tear after 5 years or 2.5 years. So you might have to replace the springs. Maybe just have to brush up the hardware with some rubber coating, or probably have to replace the spring after 4 years. No big deal. As you can see, I put some rubber coating between the bolts right here on the pole. I masked off like this much or this much and put some rubber coating on this to protect the pole from rusting, because it was starting to show some rust streaks, like as you can see right here. Well, that, as you know, that's kind of W40 coming out of the pole. So if far for the 2.5 year review of this, it's shown normal wear and tear. But the, I'm going to compliment Lifetime by saying their basketball team still runs. Well, their basketball team still works after 2.5 years. Lifetime, if you're watching my video, please send me a new part of this, because this rubber coating that I put on the silver piece is starting to peel. Probably got to recoat this with some Plastidip. Yeah, as you can see right there, Lifetime, I put swirls in the piece because it started rusting out and I needed to get the rust off, so I had to take a wire brush on my drill and put all the swirls in the piece of metal, took all the galvanized coating off. But the complaints I'm gonna say, Lifetime, is I need my powder coating freshened up. If you're watching this, Lifetime, if this video goes viral and they see it, just please offer me some fresh powder coating. I really need it. And the ground sleeve that I put in the ground, the powder coating got chipped in the concrete with a shovel. But as you can see down here, I had to put some more rubber coating on this. I had to put some rubber coating down there. It's all the concrete. It's ground sleeve or stuff. I'll probably just plaster up the whole thing. Maybe vinyl wrap it. Some parts of it. But I'm still getting pretty good enjoyment out of this basketball league, guys. Don't get me wrong. It's been a pretty good basketball league for 2.5 years. I got it in January of... I think I got it in January 2017. The chips could have been from just normal installation. Probably just accidental problems that I'm probably gonna peel all this off. It's driving me nuts how I put the rubber coating on and start to peel. So far, it's been a pretty good basketball hoop for the run of my money, my mom's money. So. If y'all enjoyed my review, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And share this video on Facebook so I can get a lot of views for it. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Keybase 879. Have a happy basketball season, guys. Because it's not going to be around much longer for winter. And peace out. Peace.